This is the second heating, making it black.
Here, then you'd have to reheat it before you dipped it.
Yes.
Okay. It's pretty warm. It's kicking out a lot of heat. That's what the copper does.
So yeah, what we want to do is we want to heat this, right?
Yep.
Okay. That's a heavy borax solution, just regular plain old boxed borax.
20 mule teams.
The 20 mule
teams. 20 mule team borax.
Yes, the old one.
Then you just rinse it off real good in cold water and rub it with your fingers. And
so you're going to do it till the black stuff is completely caked in there.
Yeah. One boxes?
It's close enough. I mean, that's a good semiconductor right there.
So it's really the reddish part that you want?
Right in here, yeah.
That's what you want to show up as a red?
Mm-hmm. It was nothing! It was an empty box with a plug on it!
And what type of copper?
Just copper, regular copper.
I mean the red, what's the distinction between the...
Corpus copper.
Corpus copper is the red one?
Yeah. Yeah, see, this will be fine. Here, Chuck, go see how you can do that. Just light.
Alum and water?
Alum and distilled water.
Yeah. And it's got to be the aluminum?
The aluminum?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Pickling alum.
Think about magnesium. Aluminum, ammonium.
If you had any galvanic action, that's what you get.
Right. See? Right.
But when you don't have the galvanic action.
So alum and water.
Add a little more.
So it's just regular paper towel?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So he's going to put the alum down in there.
No, that's a coffee filter.
Yeah.
This is a paper towel. I didn't use the coffee filter.
And that's just a pure magnesium.
I'm going to push this down. Hey, Chuck. There you go.
And we're going to get our goo here.
That's more alum?
Yeah.
More alum goo.
We don't want to waste it. I mean,
right.
We got 50 pounds of it. Want some?
Yeah. Cheaper than buying it at Walmart. $2.50 for
50 pounds we got for, how much was it, Chuck?
It was about $50, but it was $50 in shipping.
Yeah.
Okay, got
so.
It.
So that alum will bind?
Yeah, but that's like still $2 a pound.
Pretty pasty like that?
When you got bucks.
Yeah, when it's up. Well, now, if you go look at those copper bowls where the FM transmitter is running right now,
as long as you don't...
When you let it, when you sit, this will start to crystallize.
I don't think they can
cavern
as low, you know.
And they'll actually hold the water in them.
Okay, now, since the outside of the cup is semiconductive, you have to scrape through that with the quick.
Right.
Where you're going to clip that.
It's like an insulator.
Otherwise you got to dial it.
Or you can clean it really good and use the tinning solution, and then you can solder a wire to it as well.
So we're going to let it just build an elm crystal, like those things.
Right.
Does that water have to be distilled or anything, or just tap water?
Distilled.
Distilled with alum.
Distilled with alum in it, yeah.
You use alum water and an alum battery.
So that's why the vein should work fine.
Yeah. You gonna edit all this?
I don't know.
Raw and cut, director's cut.
Director's cut.
Director's cut.
Yeah. With all the words.
You're just gonna stay on the spot to put a clip?
Yep.
Never.
John was having trouble with that yellow clip lead there. It was not a good connection or something. Was, yeah, if you wiggle it over there on the light, he was playing around with that and it lit up.
Then it's hooked up the correct direction.
So the magnesium is negative and the copper is positive?
Correct. Copper is a positive gate on it. Well, it's over 30 milliamps right now.
That's pretty good.
It's over 30 milliamps and it's really bright.
Bright.
Yeah. Let me go get a decent.
Is pegging the meter.
Yeah.
Those things are bright. Here's little copper magnesium alum batteries powering this radio transmitter. There's a broadcast antenna. The only copper magnesium alum powered radio station.
Okay, now, since the outside of the cup is semiconductive, you have to scrape through that with the clip lid.
Right.
Where you're going to clip that.
It's like an insulator.
Otherwise, you got to dial it.
Or you can clean it really good and use the tinning solution, and then you can solder a wire to it as well.
We're going to let it just build an elm pit, like those things.
Right.
Does that water have to be distilled or anything, or just tap water?
Distilled.
Distilled with alum.
Distilled with alum in it, yeah.
You use alum water and an alum battery.
So that's why the vein should work fine. Yeah.
You're going to edit all this?
I don't know.
Raw and director's cut.
Director's cut.
Director's cut.
Yeah.
So you're just going to stay on the spot to put a clip?
Yep.
It's close enough. I mean, that's a good semiconductor right there.
So it's really the reddish part that you want.
Right in here, yeah.
That's what you want to show up as a red.
It was nothing. It was an empty box with a plug on it.
And what type of copper?
Just copper, regular copper.
I mean the red. What's the distinction between the...
Corpus copper.
Corpus copper is the red one?
Yeah. Yeah, see, this will be fine. Here, Chuck, go see how you can do that. Just like
to the bottom.
Alum and water?
Alum and distilled water.
And it's got to be the aluminum?
The aluminum.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Pickling alum.
Think about magnesium. Aluminum, yeah. Ammonium.
If you have any galvanic action, that's what you get.
Right.
But when you don't have the galvanic action,
alum and water.
Shake that a little more.
John was having trouble with that yellow clip lead there. It was not a good connection or something. If you wiggle it over there on the light, he was playing around with that and it lit up.
There we go. Then it's hooked up the correct direction.
So the magnesium is negative and the copper is positive?
Correct. Copper is a positive gate on it. Well, it's over 30 milliamps right now.
That's pretty good.
It's over 30 milliamps and it's really bright, man. Let me go get a decent.
This is the second heating, making it black.
Here, then you'd have to reheat it before you dipped it.
Yes.
Okay. It's pretty warm. It's kicking out a lot of heat. That's what the copper does.
So yeah, what we want to do is we want to heat this, right?
Yep.
Okay. That's just a heavy borax solution, just regular plain old boxed borax.
20 mule teams.
The 20 mule teams.
20 mule team borax.
Yes, the old guy.
Then you just rinse it off real good in cold water and rub it with your fingers. And
so you're going to do it till the black stuff is completely caked in there. So it's just regular paper towel?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So he's going to put the alum down in there.
No, that's a coffee filter.
Yeah.
Well, this is a paper towel.
Paper
I didn't
towel,
use
the
coffee filter.
And that's just a pure magnesium.
I'm going to push this down. Hey, Chuck. There you go.
Now we're going to get our goo here.
That's more alum?
Yeah.
More alum goo?
We don't want to waste it. I mean,
right.
We got 50 pounds of it. Want some?
It's cheaper than buying it at Walmart. $250 for
50 pounds we got for how much
was it? It was about $50, but it was $50 in shipping.
Yeah.
Okay. Got
so.
It.
So that alum will bind.
Yeah, but that's
like
still $2 a pound.
Pretty pasty like that when you got.
Yeah, when it's up. Well, now, if you go look at those copper bowls where the FM transmitter is running right now,
as long as they don't.
When you let it, when you sit, this will start to crystallize.
I don't think they can
go
as low.
And they'll actually hold the water in them.